My dear children, we saw how to solve an equation having variable on both the sides of an equation. Okay, so now based on that, shall we solve some more application problems? Okay, that is we should apply in our daily life. Okay, that is application sums. Okay, see, we have the digits of a two-digit number differed by 3. The digits of a two-digit number differ by 3. Okay. See, if the digits are interchanged, and the resulting number is added to the original number, we get 143. Okay. So what can be the original number? Okay. See, if we are reading once a question means we can't understand what we want to do. Okay. You should read twice or three times a question. Then only you come to know what you want to do and what you want to know. Okay. Come to know. Okay. See, the last time, what can be the original number? Okay, so we want to find the number. Okay, so we want to find the number. Okay, see, the digits of a two-digit number. The digits of a two-digit number means we have two-digit number. Okay, so differ by 3. Differ by 3. Okay, so let us take an example. I'll give you an example, not this question. Okay, I'll give you an example. Okay, 1, 4, 14. 14 is a two-digit number. Okay, so it differs 3. It differs 3. But what is the difference? It differs. The digits of a two-digit number differ by 3. Okay, so differ by 3 means the first number is bigger number. Okay, that is, it is in tens place, 41. Okay, so we have a ones place 1. Okay, so 1 plus 3, we have 4. Okay, so now here it is 4. But we don't know what is the number. Okay, so let us assume the numbers. Okay, then if the digits are interchanged, that 2 digits, we have 41 means, okay, that 2 digits are interchanged, plus 14. So these two are interchanging means, like that, here it is given, not the exact this numbers, okay. So like that, here it is given 2 digit number, okay, like that, that 2 digit numbers are interchanging means, the answer is how much? 143, it is given, okay. So if the digits are interchanged, and the resulting number is added to the original number and the resulting number. See, if this digit is interchanged, we are getting this resulting number. This is called resulting number is given. See, if the digits are interchanged, okay, and the resulting number, the digits are interchanged, this is the resulting number, is added to the original number. That is, we have a two-digit number, no, that is original number. This resulting number is added to original number, that is, we get the sum, that is, added, we get the sum as 143. Okay, let us see what is that number. Okay, see, solution. Let two-digit number, it is given. Okay, let the number which is in ones place, okay, let the number in ones place. Two-digit number means you know in a place value chart ones and tens. Two-digit number means ones and tens. Okay. See here, let the number in ones place. Let the number in ones place be. We should take B. Usually we are taking, we are using X. Okay. We are assuming anything. Okay. X. But here in your textbook it is given by B. So we are take B. Okay. So the number in ones place B. B. Okay. Then Then what is the condition it is given? The two digit number differ by 3. Okay, so differ by 3. The number in tens place of the two digit number. That is in tens place. In tens place, we want to multiply by 10. Okay, so 10 into. So this tens place number is differs by 3. Differs by 3. So we are adding b plus 3. Okay, so b is in ones place. B is in ones place. So in tens place, b plus 3. It differs by 3. Okay, so 10 into b plus 3. Okay, so then we are adding these two numbers. Okay, we are writing these two numbers. We have a two digit number. Okay, we are adding these two numbers. We get a two digit number. Okay, that is 10 into b plus 3 plus b. Okay, that is equals to this. We can write it as 10b plus 10 into 3, sorry, 10 plus 10 into b, 10b plus 10 into 3, 30 plus b. Okay, then this we can write as 10b plus b, 11b plus 30. 11b plus 30. Okay, so this is a two digit number. It is given the digits of a two digit number differ by 3. Okay, 11b plus 30. And then if the digits are interchanged, see, if the digits are interchanged, means b comes to here and this 10 into b plus 3 comes to in one space. Isn't right? 10 into b plus 3 comes into one space. Okay, so here that is 11b plus 30. Okay, now see, we should see the next. That is, if the digits are interchanged and the resulting number is added to the original number. See, first we found out the number, two digit number, that is 11b plus 30. Okay, this is two digit number, 11b plus 30. Okay, then we move. If the digits are interchanged, how to interchange? See here, b is in one space. Okay, b is in one space. Okay, then 10b plus 3 is in 10 space. Okay, so this is 10 space and this is one space. Okay, this is one space. So we are interchanging this. See, b becomes into 10 space. B plus 3 comes to 1 space. Understood? See, B, 10 into B plus 3 is in 10 space. B plus 3 is in 10 space. B is in 1 space. We are interchanging these two. B comes to 10 space and B plus 3 comes to 1 space. Understood, children? So now we can write. Okay. That is, the digits are interchanged. When the digits are interchanged. When the digits are interchanged, we get, see, 10b. Okay, b comes in 10 space plus b plus 3 comes in 1 space. B plus 3 comes in 1 space. Okay, that is 3 is added to a 1 space number. It differs by 3, you know. So b plus 3 comes in 1 space and 10, b comes in 10 space. Okay, so that is 10b plus b, 11b plus 3. 11b plus 3. Okay, so this is equation 1 and this is equation 2. We should take like that. Okay, so no confusions here. So you B comes into 10 space and B plus 3 comes into 1 space. So 10B plus B plus 3. So here 10B plus 3, 11B plus 3. Okay. So now we should add, that is the digits are interchanged and the resulting number is, the resulting number is 11B plus 3 here. We are interchanging the digits this. Okay. 11B plus 30 is the first number. Then from that we are interchanging the numbers, we get 11b plus 3. Okay, so if the digits are interchanged and the resulting number is added to the original number, the resulting number is added to the original number. Okay, the resulting number is added to the original number. These two we are adding, the answer we get the 143. Okay, that is 11b plus 30 plus 11b plus 3, that is equals to 143. Understood, children? See here, we should solve this. 11b plus 11b, grouping the terms. You read it from 7th standard itself, okay? You read already in your class 7. See, grouping the terms. 11b plus 11b, 22b. Plus 30 plus 3, 33. That is equal to 143. Okay, children. Okay. After that, you want to solve the equation to find the number B. Okay. See here, 22B. Once again, I am writing the equation here. 22B plus 33 equals to 143. Okay.
Fine.
just age. Okay, see, 5 then present ages. Okay, now let us take Shriya's age be x years. Shriya's age be x years. Then Arjun's present age be 2x years. That is twice. Okay, see, twice. Okay, see, Shriya's age here taken it as x years and Arjun's age twice as old as Shriya. So twice means we can write 2x years. Okay, so let us take Shriya's age be x years and Arjun's present age be 2x years. Okay, then 5 years ago Shriya's age be x minus 5 years. Okay, 5 years ago, that is given another condition, 5 years ago his age, that is Arjun's age, was 3 times Shriya's age. Okay, so 5 years ago Shriya's age be, that is now present age is x years. Okay, 5 years ago means we want to minus this present years. Okay, now you have 12 years old means, that is 5 years ago means we are, that is subtracting 5 years from present age. Okay, that is 12 minus 5. Here we are taking present age is x. So 5 years ago means x minus 5 years. Okay, children. Then 5 years ago Arjun's age be. 5 years ago Arjun's age be. So our present age of Arjun is 2x. And present age of Arjun is 2x. Okay. So 2x minus 5 years. 2x minus 5 years. Okay. See, that is 5 years ago Arjun's age be 2x minus 5 years. And present age of Arjun is 2x. Okay. So 5 years ago means we are subtracting 5 from the present age. So minus 5 years. Okay. So we are comparing these two. Okay. So while comparing, keep it in your mind, what is the condition? 3 times Shriya's age. 3 times Shriya's age. Okay. So 3 times Shriya's age. So this 2x minus 5 is 3 times of x minus 5. Understood, children? See, 2x minus 5 is equals to 3 times x minus 5 years. Okay. So Arjun's 5 years ago, Arjun's age is 5 years ago, Arjun's age is 2x minus 5. Okay. So 5 years ago, Arjun's age is 2x minus 5. This is equals to. Okay. So this is equals to. Okay, so condition, his age was 3 times Shriya's age. 3 times Shriya's age. 3 times of, what is the 5 years ago Shriya's age? X minus 5. Okay, x minus 5. Okay, so 5 years ago Arjun's age is 3 times Shriya's age. That is true, children. Okay, so now we should remove this bracket first. 2x minus 5 equals to 3x minus 5 threes are 15. Okay, 5 threes are 15. Now, let us do the solution. Okay, here we have in this equation, both the sides are variable. Both the sides are having variable. Okay, so this variable, see here, 2x is lesser than 3x. 2x is lesser than 3x. So we should move in this 2x to RHS and this number 15 is transposing to the LHS. Understood? So here that is 15. Minus 15 comes to LHS as plus 15 minus 5 comes to this and equals to 3x and this 2 transposing to minus 2x. Understood? Here transposing method. Transposing here we use. Okay, good. See, the which is bigger, that should be as it is. Why? Because here minus sign should be there. The sign should be changed from transposing method. So this 2x comes to this side as minus 2x. We have 3x minus 2x, we have a plus x. Okay. So here 15 minus 5, 10. That is equals to 3x minus 2x, x. Okay. Therefore, x equals to 10. X equals to 10. So x equals to 10 means, x equals to 10 means, see, what we take x as Shriya's She has aged be 10 years. Okay. Then we want to find out the opposite, Arjun's age. Then Arjun's age be 2x. Yes, we take 2x. That is equal to 2 into 10. 20 years. Okay.
Message me and ask. Okay, ask me. I'll clear your doubts. Thank you, children.